You're watching The Dish TV, the talk show from SRI International that highlights the most important part of our institute, our people. I'm Reenita Hora, head of marketing and communications. Today I'm joined by Alexander Kernbaum, senior manager and principal research engineer at SRI Robotics. I asked Alex about the Abacus Drive, a new rotary transmission developed at SRI International to improve the safety and efficiency of robotic systems.
So Abacus Drive is a new kind of rotary transmission that you could use in robotic applications or in automotive, lots of different possible applications.
What is significant about this particular kind of rotary transmission drive?
In most applications like robotics, you want to have really small motors because of weight concerns. And that small motor means that you want to have a transmission ratio, a rather large transmission ratio between that motor and the output. So the motor might spin at like 6,000 RPMs, but the limb of the robot might only spin at a few hundred RPM. And so that kind of mapping from high speed to high torque is what the transmission does. There are a couple designs that have really taken hold in the market for industrial applications. And for instance, one of those is a harmonic drive. So that's what we have here.
And that is a gear-driven drive, is that correct?
Yeah, so it has gear teeth, that's right. And it's a fixed ratio transmission, which right now nearly all robotic applications use single ratio. And so in this case, it's a 50-to-1 ratio.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is what's used in industrial applications right now. And in industry, they care about things like precision of the output is very important because they want to be able to do tasks repeatedly without sensors, essentially. But they're not very well suited for mobile robotics, and they're not very well suited for human interaction, for human safety issues.
So was that the intent when you developed the Abacus Drive? You were thinking specifically of designing it not for industrial robotics, but more for humanoid robotics?
Humanoid is actually where we started. We developed a platform called Proxy, which is a full-scale humanoid. And we're proud to say it's the most efficient full-scale humanoid, and it uses a very, very low amount of power. So efficiency was important for us for two main reasons.
Mm-hmm.
One of them was for long battery life, because these are mobile platforms, they have to move around. So Proxy could operate for 8 hours at a time with one battery. And the other one was because of this human safety concern. And so we found that by developing our own transmissions for Proxy, we were able to have better human safety and better efficiency.
What were the challenges or the pitfalls, if any?
Our first effort in Proxy was not actually Abacus Drive. Proxy was our motivating source for Abacus Drive. So for instance, this is a transmission from Proxy. It's a cycloid transmission. And cycloids have been known for several hundred years now. This one, though, has really nice efficiency because we use these needle roller bearing elements. So instead of having gear teeth, you're rolling on bearings instead of gear teeth.
To understand that clearly for the mm-hmm. layperson,
mm-hmm.
gear-driven means you've got two sets of gears and they're rolling off of each other,
mm-hmm.
or I should say in conjunction with each other, whereas cycloid-driven transmissions have no gears.
So a cycloid transmission can have gear teeth. And you can think of these lobes that you see as being the gear teeth. And in some more classic cycloids, this is called a ring gear, and the gear teeth are pointing inwards.
Mm.
So the interesting thing about this drive is that we've replaced the outer gear teeth with roller bearings. So it's a pure rolling cycloid, essentially. And that's how we got the high efficiency.
And that is the main reason to do this, is to increase the efficiency.
That's right, yeah. But one of the challenges was that, well, first off, these needle roller bearings turn out to be very expensive,
mm-hmm.
and this drive has 30 of them. And another challenge is that we actually wanted to have a higher ratio in this form factor. We were hoping to have a 30-to-1 ratio in here, but this is a 14-to-1. If we wanted a 30-to-1, then these needles would have to be impossibly small. It was also a great opportunity for us because typically when you design a robot, a humanoid or otherwise today, the first thing you do is you go buy a bunch of harmonic drive transmissions. And they're wonderful transmissions. We were able to start with a clean sheet of paper, and that really allowed us to sink into the problem space. And I think that was that was really the beginning of the Abacus Drive story for us.
Show me Abacus Drive then.
Yeah, so here's an early implementation right here. And you can see the way that it works is that in this drive here, we've got these needle roller bearing assemblies. They've been replaced by these rather large rolling elements, these spherical elements. And what's happening is that these spherical elements are rolling in and out of a raceway, like a ball bearing, like a regular ball bearing, but the raceway has this undulating wave shape. And if you look through here, you can see some of that wave shape right there.
Yes.
And that allows the spherical rollers to always be changing diameter. So sometimes this spherical roller is very small, and then the next moment it's very large. It turns out that it allows it to always be just the right size at the right time to get you this pure rolling motion. So you get really, really low friction. You can see here, this is just a prototype, but you know, if I spin it, it just keeps on rolling. And you get that with no gear teeth. So it's also very quiet as well and very precise.
Fantastic. It looks very much like, to me, the solar system.
Yeah.
So Alexander, tell me then, where is this being used? Where in robotics, or in what robotics, I should ask, is it being used today?
Abacus Drive is still in the development process. We have a commercial partner, which is Harmonic Drive Systems, and they've been funding development work for several years now. So we're still sussing out what the right market is. One area that I'm interested in is actually back to classical industrial robotics. The market already exists, and there's a good opportunity there to have more efficient transmissions that are still very high performance. So that's one potential market. And the other one, like we're motivated by with proxy, would be a cobot of the future, for instance. So perhaps a low ratio transmission, maybe 25 to 1, 30 to 1 ratio. Very, very efficient, maybe 96, 99% efficient, and very back drivable. So for instance, if the robot were to bump into you, it would simply naturally stop moving. And if you were to push it, it would move out of the way. And that's something that industrial robots don't have right now.
Am I right in understanding then that a cobot is a useful robot used in a commercial application, or is it a robotic friend?
If you try and go buy a cobot right now, what you are actually buying is a smaller industrial robot that has been sold as a cobot because that's an exciting new brand. I would argue that these small industrial robots, they're using the same technologies that industrial robots use, and so they're actually quite handicapped in that space. They still have very high ratios, they have a lot of inertia. I think that we'll see a next generation of cobotics in industrial settings in the next 5 to 15 years that will be using new novel transmissions, and perhaps Abacus Drive will be part of that.
So will it really be that long, that far into the future, 5 to 15?
One of the things about hardware is that it simply does take time to develop. And so that's something that sometimes the only way you know if something is going to work well is to build one, and building one can be a multi-year process.
What can we expect to see next coming out of this project here at SRI?
We keep on finding new and interesting things to improve upon. So with Abacus Drive, for instance, we were at this point several years ago, but we discovered that we had introduced a problem, and that problem was that the position of these rolling elements wasn't really properly constrained enough. And that inaccuracy of position allowed for undesirable effects in the transmission ratio. And so most recently, we're just highlighting this new kind of Abacus Drive here. So this is more like the kind of thing you might see in the market, although this one's made of clear 3D printed material, so you can observe the inside. But this one has two rows of Abacus rollers out of phase with each other, so it's more balanced. But the funny thing is that we discovered we could keep the Abacus rollers in just the right spot by attaching adjacent rollers to each other. So each roller is actually mated to another roller on the other Abacus drive.
Interesting.
Yeah, and that was really surprising to us, that you could still have this pure rolling motion with a very complex kinematics. It's a very simple mechanism, but each roller is simply keeping the other roller in just the right spot by being physically attached.
And this also works to that ultimate objective of keeping the robot, or making the robot, more efficient.
Yes, absolutely.
Lighter.
Yeah, exactly. And by keeping the rollers in the right place, you get more efficiency. You also get smoother ratio. So sometimes in any transmission, you think of it as a 3-to-1 ratio, but actually that's the average in reality, there's like a little bit of a vibration that you'd see in the output. And so this is a smoother operation as a result of that.
So would it be unfair for me to ask then if there is a project that you're looking at beyond the Abacus Drive that would be a next phase, but after the Abacus Drive?
We're always trying to come up with new ideas. And something I'm looking forward to maybe talking about next time would be another project that we have. It's called Inception Drive. So Inception Drive is a variable ratio transmission that is compact enough potentially for robotics applications, but could also be used in the automotive space. So currently we argue, why are all these fixed ratio transmissions used in robotics? Well, it is expedient. It's not as complex as a variable ratio transmission. But we think it's also just because it's hard to make them compact enough for robotics. If you could have a small enough variable transmission, there would be lots of use applications.